another really cold one.
Cold weather at the CBSDC.com Weather Center, WUSA 9. First alert, meteorologist Howard Bernstein.
Well, gusts early over 30 miles an hour, with highs in the upper teens, maybe 20 if you're lucky. Wind chills, though, this morning could be in the 5 below to 15 below range in the metro. Tonight, clear.
These are some of the little spinner baits that I've made. I actually made these with the idea of taking them trout fishing. I got that tiny little hook on there. That should be a nice sticky hook. These I made with the Do-It mold. I think it's called a crappy spinner, but kind of reminds me of Beetle Spin. Put the soft plastic on there that glows. We did well with the trout Sunday. And these are some of the jig heads. This is the one that I did well with last time we were here. But I'm going to try, this is a football head with the same kind of screw lock in there. And I also going to try the football head. This is a 16th ounce football head without the screw lock, and I used a much smaller hook on this one. At least all this snow makes it easy to drag the kayak.
What I'm doing here is throwing a 3¼-inch fluke that I poured. It's very similar to Jeff's Mama Chug color. And it's rigged on an 1/8-ounce dragon head. And I applied these little sticky eyes and kind of dipped it in some clear plastisol afterwards. Just dead sticking it along the bank. It's gotten a couple this morning already, so hopefully get a couple more.
Alright, got a nice one on the spinner bait. One of the first cast for that spinner bait I made for the trout fishing. He's running off some line. Yeah! I dropped it on the bottom. Almost, you know, when you fish spinner baits in cold weather like this, you almost want to tell yourself, hey, I got a jig here. And you let it sit on the bottom as though it were a jig. And then you come back to fishing it like a spinnerbait, almost like a swim jig. You know, you move it along and then let it sit on the bottom. Let it sit there 10 seconds, sometimes 20 seconds, and then move it a little further. Crappy spinner bait. Alright, on that 1/8-ounce crappy spinner bait. Tiny little Colorado blade I stuck on there. That one's a gold one. I got some hammered. A couple different blade combinations I got. Mostly Colorado. So that's what I'm working with. Alright, now there's some bigger ones in here, but it's nice to go tinkering with something, come up with an idea, that finesse crappy spinnerbait, and have it work.
This one's on a homemade swim bait, 3-inch, kind of Reaction Innovation style mold with a 1/4-ounce dragon head. Real slow and steady retrieve with a pause in every probably about 3 or 4 seconds. Let's get another one. Last few minutes of daylight here, the temperature's definitely dropped off. I just got my best of the day on a 3-inch swim bait. Jeff and I have been picking up 12 and 13 inch fish pretty steadily here within the last couple hours. And here we are at the last hour of daylight. And I've been throwing a 3-inch swim bait that I pour myself. And more or less, this is just a bunch of colors combined from other plastics I've had left over with a little bit of gold at it. It's rigged on a 1/4-ounce dragon head. And we're fishing an embankment with a ledge system, pretty much the first pool that we started in. We got one or two smaller ones out of it, and then picked up this 19-inch fish on a slow roll to a dead stick retrieve on a swim bait.
Glad to be home in a warm house. I think that was the coldest air temperature day that I've ever fished in. It's not the coldest water temperature I've fished in, but it was pretty brutal. The better fish that we caught, Jed's 19 at the end of the day, a couple that I caught on the spinner bait, they had one thing in common, and I did a little illustration to show what that's about. Low and slow in the snow. whether we were using the spinner bait or Jed using the swim bait, we were kind of doing the same thing. You know, cast it up on the bank or wherever, let it flutter to the bottom, and then just let it sit there 10 seconds. You know, give it a little bit of a rip, move it a couple feet, and then let it sit another 25 seconds. You know, hop it another foot, give it another 15. You know, and so on. And you're keeping it near the bottom. And really, when we think of spinner baits and swim baits, we think of a retrieve that is put it out there, bring it back, put it out there, bring it back. And really, I have a backlash to thank for figuring this one out. I was fishing on a reservoir, and I put a short arm spinner bait out there in the middle, just chucked it a long way, and it backlashed. And as I was picking the backlash out, it was probably 2 minutes or more. I got it fixed, and as soon as I started ripping it, bam, there was a fish. And he had been sitting there the same way that I think when we put these lures down here, you know, they flutter to a stop. And I think they, you know, in that motion, you know, the flash or whatever it is about the lure, they see it. It takes them, you know, a long time to come over and check it out. It'll flutter along, and you know, you let it sit there for 25 seconds. It might take them 15 seconds if they're 5 feet away to move over in cold water, and they'll just be sitting right over it. And as soon as it starts moving, it is usually when they jam it. So, you know, just because you have something that you traditionally fish with a cast and retrieve presentation, you know, think of it like a jig. Don't think about a spinner bait or a swim bait. You know, you're pausing it up to 30 seconds and you're moving a short distance, keeping it close to the bottom, and you're just gliding it. You know, you can use this, you know, with spinner baits, swim baits, tube, chatter baits, grubs, any other jig and soft plastic combo. You know, you're just giving them the time to come over and check it out, and as soon as it starts moving, they're on top of it. So, low and slow in the snow.